I'm gonna ask Miani Lawson to come up. She's gonna introduce me and tell you a little bit about our experiences working together. Come on.
Do you want to stand here or can I?
Wherever you want.
Wherever I want. Hello, everyone.
Hi.
My name is Miani Lawson. I am the mother of two small children, one of them that you saw here with me. She's 2 months old, but I'm really thankful for the help that I've received from Andrew. So when he asked me to come out, I got my cousin to come with me, and we're here. So I'm very happy to come and be able to have the opportunity to introduce him. I am an educator, a teacher. I've been a teacher for about 20 years now. I've also been an educational consultant. I've done work at the university level as an adjunct faculty member. And about 5 years ago now, coming up on September, I started I opened a school, Bergen Lafayette Montessori School. It's serving children ages 2.5 to 10 years old in Jersey City, New Jersey. So basically the reason why I founded the school is because I really have a strong belief that all children should have access to educational opportunities. And in the Montessori community, unfortunately, many of the schools are independent schools and the tuition is quite high. So therefore, that very sound form of education is not available to a wide population of students. And so therefore, I felt that there was a need for that. That it would benefit my child as well as other people's children, and so I opened the school. I started in my house. I have a two-family home. We turned the first floor unit into a school. We started with 5 students and my daughter, so 6 students total, and there was myself and another teacher there. I was teaching the students in English, and she was teaching the students in Spanish. Mm. We knew that the dual language component was going to be very important because we live in a global society. All of the standards of New Jersey talk about preparing children to be prepared for 21st century college and careers. So the fact of being able to speak a second language is definitely something that we felt was important. So then what happened was I had the program in my house with those children, and I decided that I was gonna go ahead and expand the program. I actually was able to go ahead and get a commercial space. I was renting, and I'm still currently renting from a church. And then I set about going and recruiting students. We started out in the school building with 14 students and 5 faculty members. And now we've seen steady growth over the years. And in coming up on our fifth year here, we have about 45 students. And I currently employ 13 people. So yeah. It's, yeah. So I've really enjoyed acting as the head of this school at times. And at times I've been, very much ready to bail out of the situation. Because I'm like, kind of, what did I get myself into? But Andrew's been there coaching me since 2005 and really, helping me along the way. And so now the next phase of the journey is that I'm a lead founder, and we're in the process of actually, we have a proposal before the New Jersey Department of Education for a Montessori charter school in Jersey City. We've already passed phase one, and we have our phase two application in, and we're preparing to go to the state with our capacity interviews to show how we can run a free and public charter Montessori school. So this will be the first public Montessori charter school in the state of New Jersey. So hopefully we will, get through it, and I'm very excited about this next particular phase, because we'll be able to serve 160 students K-3 in the first year, and by the year 2024, we'll be serving approximately 400 students. So I'm very proud to introduce Andrew, who is our featured guest speaker. Like I said, he's been my business coach since 2015. He's really a smart guy. I don't know how many people know him, but he is. But one of the things that I really appreciate about Andrew is that he's very easy to talk to. So you can come to him, you have things that, I was not a business person at all. I have been an educator. So you can come to him with problems and things that you foresee as issues, and I used to really catastrophize situations and thinking that you know, this is the end of the world. And I was like, why I leave my teaching job? I'm not making any money. This is terrible, you know. And, you know, kind of his response was like, all right, well, what are you going to do about it? You know, like, get out there, market your business, and make it happen, you know. And so he's really helped me in terms of gaining knowledge, being able to especially obtain additional financing. So what I've been able to do is to put together financing packages, and I've been able to get loans totaling $150,000. $50,000 of those dollars I've already, you know, repaid. So all these people with this capital out there, I'm good. Not a high risk. I do pay my loans. And also Andrew helped me when I was in the Start Something Challenge. I was able to learn about pitching my business, and I was able to come in third place in that competition, and I earned a $5,000 grant for my school. So I've, you know, one of the things that has really helped me a lot is being able to grow my staff and being able to delegate the responsibilities to different people. There's a book called The E-Myth that Andrew really highly recommends, and I think it's probably his favorite book beyond the book that he just wrote. So, you know, he had me to read that book, and really it helped in terms of just being able to not just work in my business, but getting to the point of working on my business. Wow. And that's really my focus at this point. I was really starting out as a person in business who was a teacher and a mother who was looking for options for my child. And now I feel like I'm a business owner who just happens to have a child. And just, so for basically what I would like to just say in terms of introducing Andrew is that, you know, he's always encouraged me. He's always, you know, challenged me to really, you know, think outside of the box. He's helped me to create strategic growth planning. You know, I've really been able to target my efforts. I was doing a lot of target marketing, but I wasn't targeting the right market. And I was like, why, you know, why is this happening? So really focusing on, yeah, you do know how to market. You're just not marketing, you know, to the right clientele that you want to serve. You know, I'm not going to act like running a small business is not difficult. It is very hard. How many people in here actually are small business owners? So you already know. Right, it's a day-to-day hustle when you're trying to, you know, get it done. But I feel like what has happened with the work that I've done with Andrew is that I've learned how to use the tools. So instead of me, for example, you know, trying to dig a swimming pool with my bare hands, I feel like I have a backhoe or some type of tools to be able to do that, and it makes it all the more easy. So overall, you know, I feel like Andrew's provided me with valuable feedback. He's given me lots of comments. He's given me great ideas for my business, which has allowed it to grow. And it's now my pleasure to invite Andrew Frazier to the podium to share his methodology for overcoming your greatest fear.
Okay, well, thank you, Miani. That's a great introduction. She introduced me once a couple years ago. I was like, you have to come back. She does such a great job and appreciate it. And it's been great working with her. She's doing tremendous things. And every year, her business grows. She's learning more. She's doing more. And she's doing what she loves and making the difference that she wants to make in the community and for young people. And education. So that's really what small business is about, having an opportunity to really make the difference that you're excited about making. So today I'm excited to have a chance to share a little bit about what is in the book that I'm releasing today as well, called Running Your Small Business Like a Pro. And you know, hopefully it wrote it based on my experiences working with hundreds of entrepreneurs and business owners, and you see common patterns and common things that everybody runs into. So sort of pointing some of them out and how to overcome them, and then coming up with a methodology for really being able to not only be reactive, but be proactive in building your business. So if that that's okay, let me get started and share a few things. So, of course, you know, my book's released today, and today you can get it for $20 instead of $25. So it's a good deal, but it's worth well more than that. There's a lot of knowledge in that, and you know, hopefully it helps a lot of people. Okay, so overcoming your greatest fear. So from a lot of entrepreneurs and business owners, run into like one fear that overshadows most others. So we've got a lot of entrepreneurs and business owners in the room. So what's your greatest fear as far as your business? Rob?
Well, I think it's mainly not having enough time to call.
Okay. That could be a fear. A lot of people would love to have that fear, but you know, definitely, you know, important. Anyone else? Jack, you want to share?
Not meeting the objectives that you lay out for yourself.
Okay, not meeting your objectives. Okay, great. Frederica?
Sure. Failure. I think that's
one
number one.
Failure. Okay, failure. No, definitely nobody wants to fail, so that's important. You want to?
I think for me, because I run a nonprofit, is feeling that I don't have the knowledge or skill set.
Okay.
To run a nonprofit.
Okay, definitely. Knowledge and skill set. There's so many things that you need to know as an entrepreneur and business owner. It's not possible to know all of them, but that's why you have to build your knowledge, build your connections and resources, and continually be learning. So, you know, definitely all of those are key, but none of those are the ones that, you know, I find as the biggest one. So any idea or guess what that might be? Yes, sir.
Finance. Going broke.
Going broke is its key and it's associated. But it's really fear of numbers and quantitative information. Most business owners and entrepreneurs, what they do is focus on selling and qualitative information. But not really looking at their numbers, using the numbers to run the business. Many times they don't even want to know what their numbers say because they don't want to be confused with the truth, or they don't want to know their numbers. But it's critical if you have a business, because business is about making money, and making money is about numbers. And if you don't know your numbers, you're not doing a good job running the business. So, you know, it's key that you need to use qualitative and quantitative information to make the best decisions possible. Let's take a look. You know, when you're starting a business, you know, you obviously have reasons and a rationale to why you do that. And usually there's three key components to it. Sometimes it's personal, sometimes it's financial, sometimes it's professional, or a combination of all three. But it's important to clarify why you're in business and what you're doing, because it's a serious step and serious consideration. And also, you know, so sometimes I find, you know, it's key to clarify that for you, because you want to know your goals and know what you want to expect out of it over the longer term. But one of the most difficult things, and what I really do for entrepreneurs and business owners, is they have their goals and they know what they want to achieve, but somewhere along the way you get stuck. You can't figure out how to move further towards what you want to achieve. So that can be very frustrating, because you're working really hard, you're making less money than you would make in a job potentially, at least early on, and you know it's not a great, and you're not sure what's going to happen. So, you know, really what this book is about, and what I do as a coach, consultant, trainer, is help you to figure out how to move your business forward, so that you can achieve the goals that you have for your business. So, you know, the first step is knowing why you're in business and knowing what you want to accomplish from being in business. The next step is you need to have a business purpose. What is your purpose? And you need to be clear on it, because sometimes there's not clarity. So, you know, it's key to make sure you have clarity. You know, there's four key types of businesses, and each one, there's different parameters, different things that you can do and accomplish. So, you know, the first is a hobby. You know, definitely people have a business for their hobby sometimes. They want something to do, or they like golf and they want to be around golf some more, so they might do something golf related, but they're not really focused on making money or making too much money. They're just doing something that they like to do. And sometimes people don't recognize that.